Dana with the task of letting me know when Donnelly goes live. Because every single show, I never see the first person, their notification.
Oh.
And it's not because I'm not following them. Of course I'm following them. I don't ever see the notification that they've gone live. So someone has to kind of be my eyes and ears, or I guess just eyes, and then come back and tell me, oh, they've gone live. So while we are waiting for Donna Lee, she's live. All right, I'll see you guys in a few more minutes. Bye.
Hello, everybody. I'm just going to give a minute or two for everyone to get in. Okay, I've got that one, the other one. Hi, everybody. How's everybody doing tonight? Sorry about that. I came barging in the room. All right, I'm just going to set my timer here real quick. And if everybody would, just invite your followers. And I'm going to do the same, I think. Although mine probably got notified when I went live. But I will put it out there again. And I'm going to share it on Twitter as well. So hopefully you all can do that too. So thanks, Natalyn, for inviting me. And today is Treasuring Memories, Episode 4. Thank you for the hearts. This is a bi-weekly event. If this is your first time and you don't know this, this is a bi-weekly event. It happens every other week. Our host is Natalyn Bradshaw, and you can find her at N as in Natalyn, P as in Peter Bradshaw. And I'm Donna Lee, Stampin' and Scrappin' with Donna Lee, and you can find me at Otters LN, Otters Lane. I have a fascination with otters. And then I'm going to be followed by Lori, which is Opa Dopa Delights. And Lori, I listened to you earlier today. And enjoyed that. And then we have the lovely Dana, which is Da Poppins. And she's a nanny by trade, so it's a cute name. And then Natalyn's going to round us out. And we would love to have you join our Facebook group. And you can find us at facebook.com/groups/ N as in Nancy, P as in Peter, Voices, V-O-I-C-E-S. So, hopefully you can join the group. We would love to have you and love for you to share your voice and however you would like to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and start my timer and we'll get started. All right, so today I want to share with you a mini album that I created many, many years ago. And this is a mini album based on a letter that my grandfather, who I call Poppy, it was based on a letter that he wrote me when I turned 20 years old. So that was 30 plus years ago that he wrote that letter to me. And he has since gone home to be with Jesus. So, I made this book, and you'll see that I have copied his letter, parts of his letter to me for my 20th birthday. And I did a color copy on some linen acid-free paper so that it would last, stand the test of time. And I've used that as the basis for writing the book, but I've also used Psalm 139, which I'll just go ahead and get us started off with that. I'll read a little bit of that because that is the scripture that is on the front cover of this book. And this is a handmade mini album. I've just got it closed with simple ribbon and paper folding. So let me just read this and then we'll get started. It says, Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I stand up. You understand my thoughts from far away. You observe my travels and my rest. You are aware of all my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you know all about it, Lord. You have encircled me. You have placed your hand on me. This extraordinary knowledge is beyond me. It is lofty. I am unable to reach it. Where can I go to escape your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I live at the eastern horizon or settle at the western limits, even there your hand will lead me. Your right hand will hold on to me. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me and the light around me will become night. Even the darkness is not dark to you. The night shines like the day, and darkness and light are alike to you. For it was you who created my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I will praise you because I have been remarkably and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful, and I know this very well. And it goes on, but I know that y'all have Bibles and you have access to them, so I'll let you all finish it. But this book I created for my three sons because I wanted them to know who my Poppy was. By the time they came along and were starting to know him, Parkinson's disease was taking its toll on his body, although his mind was always good even until the very end. But I really just wanted them to know the man that he was. So this is my Poppy as a very young man. And I have a cover. This is a cover. And I've just used a simple hinge with, little brads to close. It's very basic. So this is a letter that I wrote, and it's a prayer. It's my prayer. I'm just thanking God for my grandparents who raised me. And my book is titled Poppy's Prayer. And my Poppy was a prayer warrior. And I'm going to have to switch this around, so y'all just bear with me. It's just the nature of the book. This is my Poppy and my granny. And my parents were divorced before I was three, or by the time I was three. And we had to go and live with my grandparents for several different reasons. But they are a treasure, were a treasure to me. They still are a treasure to me. And that's one of my favorite pictures of them. And that was when I was very little, that picture was taken. So I have taken Psalms 139 and another psalm because it was one of my Poppy's favorite psalms. And Poppy would pray out loud at night. And he would oftentimes recite the psalms and different scriptures. So I've included those on these tags or behind some pictures as we go through the book. But you can see the letter. Part of the beginning of the letter that he wrote to me. He had beautiful, absolutely beautiful handwriting. And I've just taken it and cut it and kind of inked the edges and antiqued the paper a little bit. And have just put it in the book. So that's the first page. And we're going to switch it around. And this is my Poppy with my oldest niece. And I'm about out of time, so I'm going to have to wrap this up. Let me turn that off. And it's my oldest niece, but you can see that I've kind of just gone through and I have tucked in these, more of Psalm 139, more of his letter to me. And that's another one of my nieces in there. These are some of my favorite pages. This is my oldest son and my niece who were born a month apart from one another. And then we have, and this is my Poppy with my oldest son again. Both of these are them together. And let's see, this one. This page is my grandparents, my Poppy and Granny, on their 45th wedding anniversary. They did make it beyond 50. They are such an inspiration to my husband and I. And this tag just has more of his letter. So you can see that I have just kind of taken it apart and cut it apart, inked it up a little bit, and just have it tucked into this album. And then on the very last page, more of the letter is here. The end of his letter to me is there. And I wrote my sons a little note about why I created the book, and it is tucked into a pocket behind the letter in a little handmade envelope. I like making my own little envelopes out of papers I have left. And it's just a note to my kids about my puppy and why I created the book and who he was and who he was to me, because quite literally, my grandparents, because I did not have my parents with us all the time, and even when my mother was with us, she wasn't really there emotionally. So they were just really an inspiration to me, and they were Jesus's hands and feet in our lives. So this is my little mini album called Poppy's Prayer, and on the back I just used a stamp that I had and put my signature on it there at the bottom. So thank you all for coming so much. And let's see, we have Lori's coming up. So Lori, did you put up your emojis? Because I totally missed it. If you did, I'm sorry. So where's Lori? I don't know if I'm going to get a notification. I followed her earlier because I didn't want to miss it. I don't know if y'all got to see the poet. I forget what we call it. It's poetry. I'm at a loss for words. So anyway, I don't know if you got to see it. Ah, there she is. There's Opa-Dopa. Where you at? Where are you, Lori? Poetry slam. Thank you. Thank you. Yep. So, I don't know if you got to see that, but I watched the replays because I was busy with my two older grandchildren. So I got to watch all the replays, and it's awesome. So if you didn't catch it, go find it in the replays on Periscope, and you will be blessed. And Natalie, I really enjoyed your sharing on the poet slam today. So anybody have any questions for me? Be sure to join. Opa-Dopa is live. Great. So everybody go over and follow her, and that's OPA-DOPA-DELIGHTS. And I will see you over there. So I'm on my way. Bye. I am going to try to get out.